Welcome back. The OpenMW team is proud to announce the release of version 0.30.0. Keep in mind that before we hit version 1.0, which will be a fully playable replacement for the original engine of The Elder Scrolls III Morrowind, most of the engine-related progress being made involves re-implementations of features found in vanilla Morrowind. After that point, we can begin adding new features and increasing the modding capabilities of our engine with our editor. With that out of the way, let's have a look at some of what's new in this release. We now have the familiar main menu with standard options to start a new game, load a saved game, change your settings, and so on, so you all can stop asking why you're starting up in some smuggler's cave or a Daedric ruin or whatever. Ranged combat is now implemented. The player and NPCs alike may now use bows, crossbows, and thrown projectiles to destroy their enemies.
Great honor! I will kill you quickly!
Throwing stars!
Swimming and flying creatures are now able to navigate the vertical axis with respect to their movement. This means no more slaughterfish roaming the land, and cliff racers are now able to swoop down from their cliffs and be aggravating as usual. OpenMW no longer produces a land free of consequence. Crime and punishment is now implemented. Engaging in illegal activities where witnesses are present will result in your crimes being reported to the authorities. That's more fun this way, anyhow.
You, Inwa.
You will die where you stand.
Great honor.
Run or die. Fight, coward.
Our save file format is still under active development, and as of this version, it now saves the state of the in-game weather, the player's faction membership, the player's map markers, and the local variables of running scripts.
We make a special trip just for you. Same low price. To the three, the spirits.
We now also have quick save. We have quick load. And we have auto saving. Deleting saves is now also possible through the in-game interface. We continue to make progress in our implementation of AI for NPCs and creatures. I'll note a few examples here. NPCs following the player or some other target now run to catch up to their target when they stray too far away. Summoned creatures actually follow their summoner around now. Nifty. We are also filling in some missing holes in combat AI. For instance, when the player attacks an innocent NPC in a town, the more courageous NPCs in the town will now rush to the aid of the NPC that was attacked. Alright, moving on. OpenCS now has a preview subview that unsurprisingly shows a preview rendering of in-game objects. There are three lighting options available within the preview subview: day, night, and bright. Hopefully, this does not require much explanation. However, note that the current icons on these buttons are temporary placeholders and do not visually correspond in any way to their actual function of changing the lighting. A Appropriate icons for these buttons will be made soon enough. Keep your pants on. The region map now has a menu with selection and editing options accessible via right-click. The region map features drag-and-drop functionality like many other parts of the editor. For example, you could change a cell's region by dragging a region record from the regions table onto the cell if you should so desire. You can also drag cells from the region map to filter bars in applicable tables, such as the references table. Editing records is now possible via subviews that are accessible by right-clicking on a given record and selecting Edit. However, not all fields in every record type are editable in this way just yet. That's all for now. Understand that I don't cover every single change to the codebase in these videos. If you want to know more, please view the full changelog and release announcement on our website, openmw.org, where you can find our blog, forums, answers to frequently asked questions, and more. Also, after all these years, we are actually getting pretty close to version 1.0. This means that most of what we have left to do to reach that point is filling in minor details, finishing up features that are already mostly implemented, fixing lots of bugs, and that sort of thing. This is excellent in and of itself, but it means that these videos could start to get kind of dull. So, if you would like me to start being more selective about what goes into these videos and skip over saying potentially boring things like, "Oh, and by the way, NPCs now run to keep up with you," please let me know. I make these videos for you, not for me. Either way, if you're really interested in such small details, you should be downloading each release and testing it out on your own to get a better feel for where the project stands at any given moment, and letting us know when you find bugs and stuff. That helps us out a lot. Anyway, until next time, thanks for watching. Oh, by the way, NPCs now run to keep up-